Hi, so good morning. Today I just decided to show you what I do on a Sunday morning when I decide to go on makeup. Okay, so basically I just try my best to carve my brow in the way I can. I mean, I'm not a makeup artist, so I then go ahead to apply points all over my face. I'm a really sweaty person. Okay, so I try my best to look for what to apply to help. Straight up, I use my eye pencil. Okay, sorry, I need to apologize for this. I was trying to just probably explain everything and try to tell you how I go about it, but I realized that it's not working. So I'm like, no. Me, I shall need to tell people. I shall need to tell you how I do my eyebrows. So pardon the fact that I'm trying to explain, I'm just going to give you the explanation from here, so please listen to me. Okay, so I sharpen my brow, try to draw. Remember I said I'm not a makeup artist, so please don't, if this works for you, fine, but trust me, this is what I do to end up getting the product or the output or the makeup face for my makeup face rather. Maybe I should use that one. So I was trying to just draw my own eyebrow. I didn't learn from anywhere. I didn't go to any makeup school. It's just virtually me trying this. You get, you know, that thing you do where you're probably with a friend and you see them making up and you're like, ah, okay, it's like this. What's this thing you're using? Please tell me the name. And I just go buy them. That's what I do. Me, I don't get strength for plenty. Issue. So that's mascara one. I just used to arrange my brow very well. I'm trying to see if I can see what I'm doing. Okay, because it's pretty early. I wake up as early as 4 on a Sunday morning. Actually, I'm an early riser. Okay, so on a day I'm going to be on makeup, trust me, I'll just need to wake up early to start this brow, because if I don't do it this way, it will be hard for me to go very early. So using eye pencil, I can sharpen as many times as possible in case you're not the same and I have to come close to the screen to see. Okay, so how is the brow like? Another thing I've noticed is when you draw a brow, it's hard to get the two perfect exactly the way you want it. One is usually finer than the other. It's something I'm beginning to notice. I've noticed it for a while, but it's, when it happens all the time, you probably just say, okay, this is how it is. So you know what they do past yourself. Okay, so when I'm done drawing my eyebrow, the next thing I try to do is to conceal. Okay, I'm trying my best to use the right terms. Because there are certain terminology that are attributed with this whole thing I'm trying to do. So let me not go and start using medical terms for my makeup. Okay, so I have to conceal my eyebrow. In doing that, I was trying to explain to you here about, basically, I was trying to explain about the next or upcoming election. I noticed that a lot of people, especially we youths, we've decided to take it to another level, which I'm thrilled. I like the fact that we're taking it to that level. And the first ever PVC I had, I'm not sure I ever used it, but this one will be my first election I'll be coming out to vote. Okay, so I told you, I wanted to conceal my eyebrow. So even in my concealing, I get to still notice some hairs coming out of the line I've drawn. I still use blades to take them off. If you cannot do that one, if you're not really good with blades, please don't. So before somebody will say I was doing it this way, you probably just hurt yourself. Okay, so I use concealer to do my brow to see if I can get a very nice layout. So I think my shade is I basically have two concealer. One is Too Faced, the other one is Chestnut. So I think I'm using one is dark, one is light. I think I'm basically using the Too Faced. Okay, so I don't think the other is Chestnut. So I used Too Faced and then I try to get what I get. Okay, so in doing the up, what I do is I just use my foundation. So like I was explaining about the upcoming election, I said this is the first time the youth is taking it to this point. It's not only the youth, even the elderly, they are supporting, and I'm wishing or hoping and even praying that it will be different. By different, I mean Nigeria for once will experience a free and fair election. Do you get? Because if it happens that way, then the people's choice will just surface. Okay, so I asked somebody, because I went out and I was trying to do my car, and someone said, I asked someone rather, because the guy was trying to tell me, oh, please get a PVC and pay the awareness. I said, okay, yeah, I'm aware, but I want to ask you a question. In the day of the election, while you're preparing to go out to cast your vote, and you're being told that there are gunshots in your street, in your neighborhood, you can even hear them. What I asked him is, will you come out? He didn't even hesitate, he said no. And then I'm like, okay, so this has been my concern. Like, I feel the fact that people have gone to different lengths to make sure they become the president of the country, I am certain they will go more than anything we ever imagined, because they are also seeing what we are seeing when it comes to the people's choice. So in doing that, I was like, maybe I should suggest something. And I'm like, is it possible for them to do an online platform? There will still be a physical one. Okay, so since they don't get to see you physically, you can just do an online platform whereby the normal election, I think it takes some few hours, they will announce the winner or this, it depends on how it goes this particular time. So they extend it and allow Nigerians, because the truth is, you can't fudge it. It has to be your maybe thumbprint or something. I just need them to do something so that they would realize that we know what we want. Because if they don't do that, and I don't think anybody will hear gunshots around your neighborhood and conveniently come out of your house. Okay, so back to my makeup. I've left the first brow. I'm done, and I'm going into the second one. So I just need to understand that you're not carried away by what I'm saying. You're probably following my little way of doing my makeup. Okay, so because if they don't do it that way, the truth is, I am scared that what has been happening would happen. So whoever is involved, the body, the organization, please try to create this. It will be well for Nigerians, and we'll be really glad if this is done. So what we'll do is, we make an attempt to come out. If you cast your vote, fine. If you can't, if you can do it twice, but because it's thumbprint, it will definitely reflect that, okay, this person has done, there's one tick. So what it is online and physical. So if it shows double, it means you are able to go physical to your polling unit and you are able to vote online. This is perfect. So if it shows one physical and your online didn't work, like, this is still perfect. So if it goes still one for just your online, this is still perfect. It works. That would be like the best ever. So if you know somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody, please talk to them and let them suggest this. Because I don't want a situation whereby with all these efforts we, the youths, have put into this upcoming election, it doesn't yield to what we desire. Okay, so it would be really nice if it can happen. Okay, so that's for my suggestion to this upcoming 2023 national election. Okay, so going back into my makeup, you see, I believe in makeup. What works for you is what you do. You know, some people use really cheaper products, and if you see the outcome of their makeup, you'll be amazed. Outside the fact that, yes, you have one or two flaws, maybe when your hot start running and all of that. Why some people use really expensive makeup and you're like, why did you makeup? Yes, I know people said, yes, without makeup it's good. But then when you want to make up, you should make up in a way that suits you. What works for you is what you do. So this is me just applying my foundation. I've done the basic thing of drawing my brow. I just go ahead to I remember they said, oh, it's not rubbing, don't rub it to your face, you dab and all that. Or sometimes we just, this is me remembering that, okay, I'm not doing the right thing. Okay, so this is me trying to do the dapping thing all over my face. At a point, I'm feeling good looking at this. I never knew this combination of my foundation and my skin blend comes out this nice on the video. I'm like, oh, okay, wow, this is nice. Initially, I was thinking it's going to look whiter because I mixed my foundation. The last time I got a new foundation, I noticed it's usually a shade darker. Okay, so this really helped me to, my concealer helps me, the lighter one of it, to increase the shades a bit so that it will be able to sit well and I won't be looking from my head, I won't be looking different from the other part of my body. Okay, so after doing a thorough blend into the skin, yes, this is like basic, because if you can get it right here, then I think you're 70% done. Yes, you're 70% done. So dab seriously into the face. Don't forget to rub your neck, okay, the sides of your face, your ears. You need to also dab that too. You need to dab it into your hair so there's hardly a visible notice between where the foundation gets up to and where your natural hair ends. Okay, it's something else I noticed and I'm trying to work on. I'm usually not the type that pays me details into this blends and combination. So I'm done with the foundation. You can see there is nothing to tell that, oh, the face and the body is different. I just head on that one straight and go into the next thing I do. Okay, so the next thing I do when I make up myself is to get my, what's the next thing actually? I think I start applying foundation, and it depends on the foundation, sorry, eyeshadow. So it depends on the kind of eyeshadow you have and that you want to do. But me, for one, I'm not a very, very loud kind of person, especially when it comes to makeup. I always want to do a makeup that, even after all the plenty addition I put into my face, you would probably just not see so many color. There was a day I was making up and so someone was like, ah, there's no point. I said, hold on, when I feel like, okay, this is nice, the combo is nice, you should make up like this. But when you bring out all the plenty equipment, it's difficult for someone to understand that, ah, how come this blends and think you come out with. Okay, so this is me showing you my different sets of eyeshadow. I think it's a compact of, it's not, I think it's actually a compact of three different shades, and I quickly use my brush. So it's good to have a lot of brushes. Okay, so what I have is, I think I have two sets. One is a set of 10, the other is a set of about, I think, 35 or so. You know, when I started making up myself, I used to feel one brush can actually do the work. Why would I need to get one for this makeup? Why would I need to get one for eyeshadow? Why do I need to get one for my lips? Why do I need to get another one to brush my face? I can just use... Okay, so I understood that part, that each of these brushes have their different uses. Okay, so it's really good on that. Okay, so me, I just remembered I had to do eyeliner. You know, when I started this video, I told you I'm not a professional. I didn't learn makeup anyway. I'm just doing what I think works for me. And at any point I remember, oh, I've not done this, I just quickly, okay, let me do this. And when I remember, oh, I've not done this, okay, so there was a day my sister saw me and she said,
she was watching me. She's actually a makeup artist, and while I was making up, she probably was just fighting with me, trying to control. Oh no, you need to do this first. You need to do this first. And at the point, she gave up. And it was when I finished. She said, "So is this the rubbish you do and end up coming out this way?" So it's the output for me. It's the output for me. I'll say it's the output for me. Okay, what matters most is what I do at the end. Okay, so see me applying concealer. Contour. I try to just contour my nose so it will be looking nice. I prefer using the dry one. I just do this line, and all of a sudden I'm carrying the brush. I'm trying to do this, and the mom will be like, "Okay, so what she doing?" Okay, so imagine I'm trying to put highlighter, and I'm like, "Okay, let me put the highlighter." I'm sure when I get to the highlighter stage, or when I'm done, there are also some basic things I will do. Unless maybe I don't want to let you know the other part. Trust me, I go as far as even checking the eyebrow again. I'm like, okay, there's still some hair that are coming out, because the thing is, the cleaner the eyebrow area is, the better. So if it's clean, it comes out very well. Okay, so that setting spray, I try to shake as much as possible, because I've noticed that it settles, because mine has shimmer on it. Okay, so I end up spraying my face, and the feel is nice. I think I've had this spray for a while. It ended up putting patches on my face, which I just had to use brush to blend off. I'm giving you the original feel, the original setting, original video. So I'm not going to cut this one out, because I think when I don't shake properly, that's what happened. And I just felt like, okay, I should probably do the last one to get the final look. So how do I look? Rate me. I think I did a good job. If you think so, please comment. Remember, I told you I'm not a makeup artist. I just wanted to just show you what I do on Sunday morning. Okay, so this is me trying to use mascara to still just touch my brow. Okay, so I said it, and basically, yes, I do that. Somebody that is a professional will say this is an error. Even me, I can testify that this is an error. Okay, so imagine after doing your full makeup, including your setting spray and your feet to go, and you're like, "No, this one no enter way." Okay, let me remove it, because you know there's some things that you see, in as much as it's not the right time, but you're not comfortable because you've seen it. If you don't see it, it's a different case. But I've seen it, I can't help it. So I am done with my makeup. To me, I'm over. Okay, so look at my makeup, my bra, I didn't do eyeshadow. Okay, so what do you think? It's not noticeable. I did it actually. So thank you for watching. Okay, so I'm going to church. I go to church very, very early. Very early as 6, sometimes 4, since I'm out of the house. And the road is usually empty. But then, Baba God got me. So at the end of the day, I couldn't even video the service. And trust me, if you want to know about my service, I'll show you online clips. So I ran from the car, from the church into the car, because it was raining heavily. Okay, so this is just a run through of what I do. So thank you for watching and staying tuned. I love you. See you next time.